tell you about this girl. Maybe I should. I met her in Philly, and her name was Brian. Sugar. See, we be making love.
Okay, yeah, we're good. Testing.
Testing.
And let me see those mic levels.
First episode, whatever it's called.
Are we recording this?
We are recording this.
Hey, podcast family.
Hey, podcast family and everybody listening.
Welcome to Brown Sugar Babe. It's our first podcast, y'all. Woo!
Yes. We're ready.
Going into 2018, right?
Let's go. Single year, new me. Like, this is what they're talking
about. Yeah, definitely.
Right.
Really?
I'm just so happy that we're starting it before the new year. Because we could have easily rescheduled and been like, let's just start it first in January.
Yeah.
No, it was like, we're going to go in.
Ready.
Already ready. On the hustle.
Wow, ready.
Hello.
Why? Because that's what a brown sugar babe does.
That's what a brown sugar babe does. She plans it out.
A brown sugar
you
babe.
You plan to fail.
Hello. Say it again for the people in the back.
You plan to fail, you fail to plan. Hello. And that's what a brown sugar babe does.
Yeah.
So, okay. So, y'all want to introduce yourselves?
Go ahead and go first.
Okay. my name is Lauren, but I like Lo for short.
L-E-A-U-X.
Yeah. Why L-E-A-U-X? I just thought it was a Louisiana thing in you.
Slightly. And also, I don't know, it's going to sound weird. L-O is just, it just makes me feel weird because it's just two letters.
Two letters.
Like, it just seems so empty.
Yeah.
I just wanted something so, I wanted a lot more full, you know, a lot, you know, a little mystery. Like, who would ever think of, when you, seriously, if you ever hear Lo, you would never think it was the X in there.
Yeah.
You know? See, you like, oh.
Actually, I would because I like stuff like that.
Yeah.
And you got some good letters.
Wrong.
So when you spell it out, like, I like when I say it in my phone with the little lipstick emoji. Like, I like that.
It's cute. Thanks, well, hey, Lo with an X.
Hey, Lo with an
X. I'm Lo with an X. Okay, I'm Lo with an X. Go ahead.
Oh, you're not going to get your whole spill?
What else am I going to say?
We introduce each other first. And yeah. We'll
okay, well, I'm Cynara.
Hey, Cynara.
Cynara with a Y-I.
With a C-Y. Not S-A. Because I read it as S-Y. Or they try to pronounce it Cynthia. It's C-Y-N-A-R-A. Mm-hmm. C as in cat. Charlie. Whatever.
There you go.
Hey, Cynara.
No nickname.
We're talking about being an AA.
It kind of feels like it's AA.
Right. Yay.
Like a different AA. Oh, we have my cousin Jada. Say hi, Jada.
Jada's our live audience. She's in the back.
Just tune in whenever you feel it in your spirit.
I got you.
Okay.
And then it's me.
Not at all.
Yeah, it's Chloe. Nothing short. I mean, Chloe, if you're feeling it. Chloe, mm-hmm. Don't get confused with the Kardashian.
Hey, it's not a K.
It's a C.
It's a
Hold
C.
Down, the original.
The original.
The creator.
Of the Chloe. You gotta let them know.
Come on.
You gotta let them know.
We're so excited to be...
Recording this.
It's been in the works for a while.
It really has.
Yeah.
It was like March of this year.
Yeah.
March, April of this year.
Me and Lo were originally talking about doing a podcast with one of our friends who's currently in Thailand.
In Thailand.
Shout out to Maya.
Hey, Maya.
And we had a meeting, discussed what we were going to do, how it was going to flow, and we just kind of procrastinated and...
It just never got together.
Yeah, it never got together. And then one day,
me and Chloe met up. We were like, okay, we're just going to move forward. And we're just going to do the show, you know, just go forward. And then one day, I tweeted on Twitter. And her name is Lo.
You better plug.
Okay, plug.
And I was just talking about podcasts because, you know, I listen to podcasts like Getting Grown. Shout out to them.
Black Girl Podcast. One of my favorites.
Yeah, shout out to them. I was just talking about those, and Cynara was like, oh my gosh, yes, you know, you wanted to start one.
Text me.
And I was like, oh my gosh, like, that's crazy, because me and Chloe, you know, we started a podcast, and I felt like it would be awesome to bring Cynara in because of her the diversity because of Cynara, like her story and like her, our dynamics are so different. And I feel like a different point of view would just be her different, her point of view would be just be awesome.
Yeah.
So it just really organically came together.
It did.
Yeah, I mean, we, the fact that we kind of know each other because we all graduated.
Yeah, we all went to the same high school.
Shout out to High Tower.
So that's like our, you know, we're all from Missouri City.
Yeah. From those who don't know, it's more of a Houston, Texas thing. We're all Houstonians.
Shout out to the
you small city of Missouri City.
Yeah. So we're all connected in those ways. So
we're not going nowhere.
Yeah.
I don't know about that.
Well, I've been somewhere and came back.
So I don't know if I'm gonna be in Missouri City.
Our stories.
So I wanted to I wanted everybody to describe themselves in like one word.
Oh, here we go.
And I know it will probably be hard, but I feel like it will be so like unique for like everybody.
It's
like
so funny. Lauren asked us this before the podcast, and I still have yet to come up with one word. I feel like she gave me time to prepare, and I still don't know.
Yeah.
I know it's bomb too. Go ahead and say it.
My word is passionate.
Passionate.
I would have used that.
Because in my life and how I express myself about things that I like, I love, or I hate, it could be a bit extra. And sometimes it's a bit explosive to some. And I don't like, sometimes I'm labeled to be like, you know, like I'll be popping off or I, you know,
popping off
or loud or whatever.
Just a firecracker.
You know.
But that's passionate.
But it's because I'm just passionate. I'm passionate about myself. I'm passionate about my feelings. I'm passionate about my opinions. I'm just passionate about my life. I'm just passionate about me.
Low passion.
So I just feel like instead of people saying like, oh, you know, you're angry or you're defensive.
Yeah.
I'm passionate. Mm-hmm. And I have every right to be that way. And I've had to learn how to accept that about myself and to walk into that and be that and wear that and be okay with that.
And it's okay.
But it's a struggle because you are misunderstood sometimes. And so I carry it, you know, as a little thing, you know, a little bag of armor almost, you know. Not really armor, but, you know, it's like, I don't know. It's like, it's hard to carry, but it's like a bittersweet. It's like a catch-22 kind of thing.
I don't think there's nothing wrong with anyone being passionate.
Absolutely.
But sometimes you are taken wrong.
Yeah.
And if you be like, damn, like,
you're doing too much, or you're defensive,
and that is very offensive to me for when people tell me I'm defensive, because it's like, no, I'm not. That's just how I express myself.
Right. Passionate about this.
So I just think I have to go a little extra. I gotta go an extra couple yards when I present myself to people because I'm not always perceived as passionate.
Yeah.
It's more aggressive and intimidating. And stuff
but
like
you
that,
be
so.
Who you are.
I was just talking about that.
What I said.
What we just
said?
What I said.
Hey, Nene. Shout out to Nene. That's my girl. Love me some Nene.
You know, so piggyback on that, you know, it's crazy once we're opinionated about something specific, mm-hmm. and like if we or we have strong feelings or we're passionate, mm-hmm. it's intimidating. Why is it intimidating?
Exactly. I don't know.
Why can't I just love this and be all
on
this?
Exactly. Yeah. I honestly feel, I don't know, I just kind of feel like people who may not be as strong-willed and may not, their opinion may not stand as strong as yours, they get intimidated. Because then they start to feel like you're trying to
press
their
own stuff.
It's like, that's just how I feel. It's just me. That's how I express myself.
It's called growth.
You know? But sometimes it's hard, though, because then I'm like, dang, like, do I need to pull back a little bit so that people won't feel like I'm trying to press my opinions on them by the way that I express myself?
I just think you always, I think the motto of 2018 going into the new year for everyone is just be who you are.
Yeah,
stand in your ground.
Unapologetically yourself.
Be unapologetically yourself.
Coming soon.
That's coming soon. We are going to have a whole episode.
Me.
Being unapologetically you. I think that is the motto that everyone should take in 2018. Some people are going to get it. Some people are not. Uh-huh. The people who are supposed to get it will be in your life. The people who are not,
they won't.
They won't. Yeah. End of story.
I think I'm actually excited about the episode because hopefully by the time we get there, I'll know who I am.
That's what Brown Sugar Babe is.
I have to apologize for it.
This is the moral of the podcast. Not to jump off topic, but Brown Sugar Babe is all about you guys just kind of going through life with us. You
finding
know,
our way.
We're like all finding our way. Life. We're all in our 20s.
I won't give an age.
Yeah. But
not at all.
20-something. We're all in our 20-somethings. And we're all just trying to make sense.
Trying to make
of this whole world. That's it.
We're just trying to make
that's
sense.
A brown sugar babe. Make. Brown sugar babe is a vibe.
She's a vibe.
She's a vibe.
She's a
vibe.
Yeah. She's a vibe. She's a concept.
I'm
going to
read my thing in a
She's
minute.
A vibe.
I want
yeah.
you to...
Okay, so my word. And I said it earlier, but I don't know. I'm a little nervous to say it.
Say it.
If I describe myself in one word right now, it would be lost. Because
that's
I have
so deep.
No idea where I am. Like, my relationship's complicated. I've been married for 5 years. My husband, we've been together for 7 ever since we graduated. But I have no idea where it's going right now. We have 2 kids. I really, this parenting thing, like, I'm literally winging it every day.
Yeah.
For me, as long as everybody's dressed, fed, not bleeding, like, it's a good day. It's a good day. Or no one's crying, it's a good day. Like, I don't know where I'm going in my career. I don't know where I'm at.
That's deep.
I mean, literally, like, I don't know where I am. I don't know who I am. I'm just waking up every day.
But you waking up and
but
out,
you
though.
Waking up
and I
you
never take that for granted. Out. Never.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
That's deep for you to admit that though.
Yeah,
a lot of
now,
people
I'm off.
A lot of people in their 20s don't
will not.
Feel like
they will fake it.
They can't
say
that they're lost.
And I get tired. You know what? I was faking it for a little bit, but I'm tired of faking it. Like, I'm just tired.
Don't you get tired?
I just
lay
rather
that burden
be,
down.
Just, that's what I'm saying. Just lay it down. I'm not gonna fake for nobody no more. It's just I am who I am. Like, I don't know
I see
where I'm at.
What I
there
say.
It is.
This episode is going to be called
I said what I said.
Okay.
That's it.
That's it.
And that's what it is. So hopefully, since this is like the first episode, we can, while I'm finding myself, I can reveal checkups, updates that I find myself, and maybe at some point, I can be like, look, y'all, this is who I am. I figured it out. But as of now, I have no idea. I'm just, I'm happy to wake up every day.
But you know what makes this point in your life so powerful? That it's just so much room for growth.
Yeah.
Because of the unknown.
Yeah.
So it just makes this stage of your life so important.
I
receive
that. This is growth. Okay.
Yeah.
That's a positive twist on it. Because at first, I'm just like, I'm lost. I don't know what to
do. Hey, you're walking into 2018. An open vessel,
like a
which
canvas.
Is beautiful.
Empty canvas, ready to receive.
And I'm gonna paint it how I want it.
And that's the beauty of, and not to say that this is you're at any type of bottom, but
no,
saying,
I said I was at rock bottom yesterday. Rock bottom.
That's the beauty of being at bottom is that only thing that you can go is up.
Yeah,
like it's amazing because it's
I
can't go any lower than this.
So that means blessings is coming my way.
Shout out to the blessings
in
2018 already.
And the fact that you have so much zeal about yourself. Like, you're not depressed. Not that you're showing, you know.
Yeah.
You're not, you know, down or you don't have an attitude. You're not showing in any type of negative way, which is awesome. Like, if I saw you, I would never think that you were going through what you're going through.
And I think that's kind of like my problem. I'm known as a strong friend because I'm just going to take my emotions and kind of just put them back there and just smile. Like, I'm not going to take it everywhere with me. Even though, like, I'm hurting right now. I'm a little depressed right now. I'm a little stressed right now. Like, I'm a little everything. But I would not, I don't like to keep that energy because, what is it called? Like, I don't want anything to mess with my energy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, if I dwell on anything for too long.
Chakras.
If I dwell on it too long, then I'm going to become what I'm feeling.
Yeah.
So, if
that's
I just choose, I'm making a decision. Happiness is a choice, not an emotion.
Amen.
Amen.
Happiness is a decision, not an emotion. It's a choice.
Yeah.
You have to choose to be. I'm going to be happy. Everything is falling to shit for me right now, but I'm going
to
be happy.
I'm going to choose
and
to
I'm
be
here.
Happy.
Mm-hmm. I could be at home in a bed crying.
Man, you know, that is so crazy because this year, one of the biggest things I learned this year is that I control my own emotions.
Hello.
And I know that sounds so simple.
It's crazy.
But I'm like, yo, I don't have to let that bother me.
Yeah.
And most of the time, the things that people do has nothing to do with nothing.
Yeah, it's never
so
personal.
It's never personal.
It's
that
never
was
personal.
My motto.
Yeah.
And I learned it, actually learned it from a job I had. It was like, all business, never personal. And I can't wear my emotions on my sleeve. I can't allow things to get, it's like, why? Like, why would I? That person don't even know me.
Yeah.
You know, I used to allow things to just get to me, just be a, like, target, like a board, like a dartboard. And it's just like, why? why? Like, what's wrong with you? Like, what? You don't have to. You don't, even when people are out to, the job I used to work at, is this lady who used to come for me every day. And I was just, that was a test. God tested me. Okay. And I was at that job until November of this year. He tested the mess out of me, and I feel like I passed that test because I was able to overcome so much and be such a more positive person and, like, really learn how to do things without being emotional.
Yeah.
And being over-passionate, honestly, and being able to be professional and see people's issues and realize that your issue, the reason why you acting like that is because you got issues. So I'm going to pray for you.
It's not cool. Me.
Yeah.
Exactly. So that's the biggest thing I can control. So when you said it, like, happiness is a choice, I feel like all emotions are choices.
Absolutely.
Every single emotion is a choice. Anger is a choice. Being sad is a choice. Everything is a choice.
Being
anxious. That's an amazing power of yourself.
When you learn how to control that.
When you learn how to control it.
It's like nothing. You gotta find out how to control it.
Yeah.
This happiness and peace is unfucked with a ball.
Yeah.
Do you hear me?
Hello.
This box.
I can't wait to get there.
Hello.
I can't wait to get
there. Girl, take your time.
Take your time.
Life ain't nothing but a book. Keep writing your chapters.
It's chapter, baby. It's 2017.
Yeah, we're all a work in progress. In our 50s, we still going to be a work in progress.
See, I'm kind of like, right now, I'm just waiting for, like, in my head, I'm like, okay, I'm going to look back, and I'm going to laugh at this where I was stressing out over here. I'm just like, when am I going to laugh? Like, can you just tell me how much longer I'm going to be?
Don't put a time limit on
anything
in life. I've learned
I love the struggle, but...
No, I just kind of learned when putting a time limit on when am I going to get over this? When am I going to get that job? When am I going to do this? When am I going to do that? It only stresses you out even more.
Mm-hmm.
I think the best thing that you can do is just go through life. Go through current.
The minute
that you fight life's natural course is when you're so anxious.
That's
you're anxious because you're
fighting anxiety.
Life's natural course instead of just letting
just
it flow.
Just letting it...
What you put out into the world is what you put out into the world is going to come back. Mm-hmm. So what you need to focus on is just putting out positivity. You already said you're thankful just for waking up every day.
Mm-hmm.
Keep that emotion.
In your head.
Just thankfulness.
I'm just hoping that's going to
snowball.
As long as you take day by day. Because I've been there multiple times.
Amen.
And so, so if you do day by day, honestly, sometimes have to do hour by hour,
minute by minute.
You will get to, like, if you have to pray every minute, if you have to pray every hour, girl. Sometimes I will listen to this song, Janae Aiko, Waves.
What? That's the song. That's the only reason why, I be chilling.
You know what?
All right.
I was the same way. Like, I'm a weirdo. Like, I will literally crawl under the bed.
Yeah.
And I will listen to Janae Aiko.
Yeah.
Like, crawl under my bed in, like, a ball and just listen.
Listen
and
to
just
that song.
Back and forth.
Over, thank you, Janae, for all the good music.
Thank you, Janae. I
love her.
Because it's just like, I was just speaking to myself, just trying to get myself out of that. And so what I did was, okay, what do I need? What do I need to make me happy? I said, okay, money. Money gonna make me happy. Okay, I didn't give me another job.
Yeah.
So what I need to do, I need to apply. I set a number of applications that I will apply to every day. A number of companies I'll apply to every day. I would get up in the morning, like a job. Hello.
Yeah.
At 8 in the morning. Hello.
Yeah.
And applying on Indeed, applying, sending stuff. Like at least 5 to 10 people every single day. Follow up with people. Like, you know, companies. Because it makes you feel motivated. It makes you feel like you're doing something. It doesn't make you feel like, oh, I'm just waiting for something. Lord, please, just $1,000 just drop in my pocket. Like, no, God will help so
many. Faith without work is dead.
So if God sees that you're putting stuff into it and putting stuff into your creativity, your hobbies, or whatever you're doing, God is going to bless you.
He's going to come
through.
I receive
that. So you will be fine.
Fine.
You going to work. And then, girls, at the end of the year, hello, it's a job. And it's going to be more money. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hello.
Amen.
In
more
position,
than what you thought.
I receive that. Okay. All right. Enough about me.
Okay.
Wait. I feel like I forgot my word with this session
so
that we went
sorry.
Through.
No,
I'm kidding. I didn't know my word. One word to describe me, I feel like, would be love.
Ooh.
Yeah. I feel like I am love. And when I say that, it's just... if anyone knows me, I'm probably the sweetest person you'll ever meet. I'm very understanding. I'm very patient. I'm very I'm love.
Okay.
And I say that just to say that it's so hard to describe, but I feel it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I don't know how to put it into words, but I feel
that's,
it.
That's love.
Yeah.
That is just love.
Yeah. There's no definition to it.
Okay. It's so just, I feel it.
Yeah. I'm
yes.
just love.
That's a
vibe. Can I have you?
Right, that's a
vibe. Like, I'm available
that.
For all.
Like, I need
you know,
love.
And it's funny because it's a blessing and a curse. Just because love, of course, is an emotion that can be.
I've never seen that
love. Love is an emotion that could be, of course, given at all times.
Okay.
But one thing that I'm learning about myself is that I have to make sure that I'm giving me love before I give love to others. And that's one thing that I've struggled with throughout my entire life. I'm a very selfless individual. Mm. So I would tend to give others what they need before I fill myself up. And I'm learning every day that you cannot pour from an empty cup. Let me say that louder for the people in the
back.
You cannot pour from an empty cup. So for people who are like me, I think it's important that you be who you are. You be loving, you be understanding, you be patient, you be trusting, you be all of that. That's beautiful. But make sure that you're instilling all of those character traits in you first before you give it to other people, because that's where we can mess up. But I'm learning that. I'm a work in progress. It's I haven't been this way forever.
I should have been taking notes.
And that's important to for everybody to know. I have not been this way forever. It took a lot of trials and tribulations, you know, for me to get to this space in life. Right.
Thank you, Jesus.
But I don't regret it. And I just can't wait to see what 2018 has in store for all of us. Like, I really, for the past couple of weeks, I've been 2018 is going to be a year. I've been seeing all over my Instagram. It looks like 2017 just kicked people in their ass.
No, like, I
love, took a lot of losses.
Yeah.
Throw the whole year in the trash.
Throw it all away.
At this point, I'm like, just throw the whole year in the trash. Because when I think about things that happened, because I moved back to Houston in May.
From where?
San Diego.
California.
Yeah, it was
This man, we about to order pizza. I'm sorry. But this comment and this thing said, this vegetarian pizza goes harder in the paint. You better get the huge.
What company is that from?
Out of here. Nick's Place.
It's just a review.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But I like
hard
pizza
in the paint.
Like that.
If you
not
don't
hard in the paint,
get
though. What's hard in the paint about just vegetables?
I mean,
vegetables are good, but if you think pizza,
you know, everyone's going vegan and vegetarian now. So
vegan,
I mean,
shit.
Okay, you a vegan?
Girl, she was vegan for like two weeks.
Girl, she said, if y'all didn't hear that, Jada said she was vegan for 2 weeks.
Y'all have to get y'all nutrients.
Okay. let's not be shy. Vegetables.
I'm not saying
pizza.
No vegans, but I'm just saying that's a lot.
It's hard.
You can't have no chicken.
No cheese.
You can't eat cheese.
Cheese.
No cheese.
No dairy.
I love cheese, too.
How you
like,
eat pizza?
What's on your pizza?
Sauce and bread.
Sauce and vegetables.
What? And green peppers.
So you eat vegetable meat with
lasagna.
No pasta. I'm pretty sure there's cheese substitutes.
Hashtag
hungry. And there's cheese substitutes. You know, like there's meat, there's tofu, which is a meat.
And then people like gluten free. They don't eat pasta.
Baby,
it's a lot. Hey, it ain't for me.
They eat wheat. They be outside in their backyard.
Right.
So all the vegetarians out there, we are not bashing y'all.
My mom is a vegetarian.
No.
Lauren's mom is a vegetarian. I commend y'all for what y'all do.
I was a vegetarian until I was 8, so it's all right.
That's cool.
It's just not for me.
It was cool.
It's not for me.
I mean, after I had meat, I didn't turn back. Hello. Maybe one day. But you know, I have talked to a lot of vegans, and they say it does make their body feel a lot lighter.
Yeah.
And it makes
their energy is up too.
But that's what you said, right, Jada?
Yeah.
In the 2 weeks that you were vegan, you had some positive experience.
Yeah.
You're not bloating at all.
Yes.
And even like during like your cycle time and stuff, I wasn't cramping, none of that.
Oh, I don't know if y'all can hear Jada back there, but she said going, being vegetarian for 2 weeks, she wasn't cramping on her cycle.
No cramping.
But see, that's why the good Lord made birth control pills. Hello. Ooh. I'm just kidding, y'all. I commend every vegetarian. I do. I have wanted to try it for at least a month.
I want
to
try it. Like,
and y'all know how to eat. Let me tell y'all. The meat, the type of, the substitutions are good. Like, yeah, Morningstar and stuff like that. Like, those are really good.
So maybe I'll try it.
The idea that someone is telling me that I cannot eat what I want to eat.
Yeah. I think that's what it is. I think it's a mind thing.
Like, it's definitely a mind thing.
I can't have enough chicken if I want to eat.
It's a mind thing. It's a mind totally a mind thing.
Okay. And it's only hard if everyone around you is still eating meat.
Right.
That's the only thing.
Because you need support.
By yourself.
Right. That's what I think of when we go to restaurants and stuff. I'm like, what am I going to eat? Carrots and lettuce? Not me.
Right. Because I love salad, but I need
that burger.
Right. This one over here got wings. And I'm eating grass.
Yo. Look, I would be so upset going into Chipotle because that's my favorite place to eat. I can't have barbecue.
Go down the line. Lettuce.
Yeah. You can get the green vegetables.
I want that.
And some salsa.
And some salsa.
Oh, you can't eat sour cream.
Chloe, and some guac.
No rice.
You can eat guac, huh?
Yeah, I eat guac.
Chipotle got some good guacamole.
They do got some guac. Shout out Chipotle.
You can eat the beans too.
I need stock.
We ain't shot in Chipotle, so they sponsor us.
Hello. All right, shout out to the place that has
the guac.
Just kidding. We love you, Chipotle. Whenever you want to sponsor us, just give us a call.
Just give us a ring link. That would be brownsugarbabepodcast@gmail.com.
Right.
Boom. Okay. Shout out
but
to
no,
the email.
That's a good leeway. Let's talk about what is brown sugar babe. We talked about ourselves, but we haven't talked to you guys about what is brown sugar babe, why we're doing this.
All right, tell me why you're doing this, Chloe.
I've been a podcast fiend for a while. I actually had a podcast a year ago, my own podcast, The Chat Room. Oh, The Chat Room.
Plug that.
I mean, it's not accessible anymore, but... No, I've been really big on podcasts. I don't even listen to music anymore because I'm always listening to podcasts. And I think more than anything, I've always wanted an outlet just to talk to people just about topics. I love to talk. I'm a journalist major. I work for a news station here in Houston. I'm all about conversation. I'm all about stories. And just giving an outlet just to talk with my girls, just about stuff, and then just relay that. Because I think it's so important that you relay, not if you don't want people in your business, but I think it's important that you just kind of share stories. Because you always think you're going through stuff alone.
I was about to say, you never know who's going through the same storm you are.
And the worst feeling is to feel like you're going through something by yourself.
Right. And I just want Brown Sugar Bay to just be something that everybody can relate to. Mm-hmm. Not just women. We will have men in these shows. We're going to have a segment called Me and the Homies. Where anytime we need a male perspective, we will have a male on the show giving their advice. So we just have a lot of things in store. And Brown Sugar Babe, it's a title, but it's a vibe.
It's a vibe.
It's who you are sprinkled with a little brown sugar.
With a brown. With a little brown sugar.
Who you are sprinkled with a little brown sugar.
I just made that up. Ooh. Lauren wrote a whole poem about this podcast. We're going to let her read it.
Okay.
Lauren doesn't play. Yeah, she was a little spoken
so,
word.
So, brown sugar babes is who you are
with a sprinkle of brown sugar.
Meaning, I do want to point that out because it's who you are. It doesn't mean you're black, you're white.
Yeah,
you're
no.
You're Asian.
You're a woman. You got sugar. Not even a woman.
And brown sugar, it's like
we're women, so.
Yeah.
We're women, so.
I mean, of course this show is going to be heavy women, you know, audience. But men, you going to want to listen to this show.
Free game.
Free game.
Free smoke. Hey. Treat yourself. Treat yourself. Going to put that one in the vault.
Okay, so.
Well, what you got? What did you write about brown sugar bag?
I'm going to hear your poem, but I also want to hear brown sugar is to you.
Okay, I want to say that first. So, this podcast to me is, it's like a vessel to me for to empower women to just be themselves and to live in their truth.
Yeah.
And to realize that your truth and your life is beautiful no matter what happens.
Yeah.
no matter what comes, no matter what goes, it is beautiful. And you should never hide who you are. And you should never fake to be something that you're not.
I said what I said.
Yeah. I myself have gone through things that have tested those things, and I've struggled with that, feeling that I couldn't really walk into my situations and live within my situations and try to hide from my life and what my life was and what my life is. And I felt like at the moment that I accepted my life and stepped into my life and stepped to myself, you know, that's when you can really start to blossom and stuff.
Walking
in your truth. So I really want women to be empowered and be confident and learn things that better themselves. Because like when I listen to different podcasts, like I learn a lot,
right?
Especially from like women, like older women or middle aged, whatever. It's just like, dang, I never like self love and self care, and it's just like so mental, important. Mind, body, and soul. It's just like, wow, you know, I could do that. I know I should do that. Or it's just like to be able to listen to women and feel like you talking to your girls. If you don't have friends, you know, because a lot of, you know, some girls, they don't have girlfriends that can call them on the phone or that group or
it's not like girls trip. Life is not
exactly.
Like
girls trip. Because you know, everybody goes through their own things and have their own dynamics. So to be able to have something that you can listen to on a weekly basis, like, okay, girl, because I find myself listening to some podcasts.
We everybody like,
girl,
stuff.
Especially Black Girl Pod.
Black Girl Pod.
I be like, y'all, like, I really be feeling like we all in the room, like, y'all.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
So that's exactly what I wanted. I want, that's what Black Pod. Shout out to y'all. Brown Sugar Babe. That's exactly what I want Brown Sugar Babe to be, just like an influential vessel, empowering vessel for anybody and everybody, and a healing vessel too.
Yeah,
you know, that's what it's gonna do for me.
Right,
it's gonna heal me. I'm gonna heal myself.
We all gonna be healing together.
To be our best, to live our best life.
Your best life, literally. It sounds like a bunch of cliches, but we gonna body that.
I mean, it's a motto of life. Living your best life should be something that you wake up to every day.
Every day is a beautiful day.
Yeah.
Just go out there.
Don't you love waking up and you just feel good? Like, you wake up, it's a good
day. It's like, it's a good day.
It's like, this, you can tell, like today is going to be a good day.
It's a good day. Every day is a good day.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to get on my...
She literally wrote...
Dim the lights.
Okay, so... Brown Sugar Babe is a concept.
Mm-hmm.
She is a vibe. Deeper than poetry, sweeter than Pina.
Oh.
She's an ambitious woman just trying to accomplish her goals and live her best life.
Live her best
life. That is what Brown Sugar Babe is.
I like that.
I like that, sweetie.
I mean, when we get our Instagram up and going,
that's exactly what I wanted to put on the podcast description.
Right. I like it.
And then... it's who you are with a sprinkle of brown sugar. I wanted that to be the tagline.
I love it.
Y'all just part of the creative process.
So y'all are part of the family. What we gonna call them? The brown family.
The Brown family? I don't know if I'm about the Brown family.
Brown sugar.
We gonna sleep on it. We gonna come back.
No, they're all brown sugar babes.
Yeah, they're babes. Brown sugar babes. That's
brown sugar babes.
What's the S?
Hey, Brown Sugar Babe.
It's more than you. It's a bunch of y'all listening. I'm speaking that into existence.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be a bunch of people listening to this.
Absolutely.
So you're Brown Sugar Babes with an S. And when you're by yourself, you're one. But when we're together,
we're all.
And when y'all listen to us, listen, like, be with us. We're all sitting here sipping some Chardonnay. So when y'all listen to us, grab a glass of wine, get comfortable.
Grab a journal.
Chat with us. There will be segments where we'll be taking questions. We will be giving advice. Don't necessarily take our advice to heart. None of us are professionals here, but you know, we're just gonna give our best, you know, intake on certain situations. But we just want y'all to vibe out with us. That's really what it is. Just vibe out.
We just wanna be just the sis. We just wanna be a sis. And just be there. Assist with assistance.
Hello.
Assist with assistance.
But yeah, I can't wait until we get questions. Like, I love that. Like, give me advice, because sometimes...
Yeah.
It's a good thing.
I think I'm full of knowledge.
To get, like, diverse. You know? Get diverse, get an array of, advice. Y'all, I'm sorry. I don't know what's going on with this
Chardonnay that you drink.
I've been like, ugh.
Okay, so let me just
tell, I know everybody went around and said what it meant to you. I do agree with both of you. Brown sugar is a vibe for me. Mm-hmm. I want this to be, like, you can't really describe our podcast with any other thing, but it's a vibe.
Right.
It's a vibe. It's important to me because, like I said, the word that I would describe myself is lost. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to do a podcast. It didn't necessarily have to be a podcast. I didn't know what I wanted it to be. But then when I seen the tweet again, it just kind of spoke to me. It was like, this is your chance. I have a lot to say. I got married young. I had kids young. Now I've been married for 5 years. It's a lot.
I can't wait till people hear.
It's a lot. I can't wait. Like, legit, I have a story to tell. And I have a great opinion on a lot of things. I'm smart. Like, I'm fun. I'm a guy's gal. I'm a girl's. Well, I'm not necessarily a girl's gal, but.
You, Cynara.
Okay.
Go ahead. No, please. No. Before you lose it, please tell.
Okay.
But
I think it's so bomb. When people be like, I'm smart.
Because I am. I think that's one of my best qualities. Like, I'm smart. I'm not dumb.
I'm not saying that I feel like I'm stupid. But.
Why does that ring so much fire on you when someone says I'm smart?
Because I just think it's bomb to say that you're smart.
And you know what? Because a lot of people are not going to say they're smart right now.
I just think I don't know. I feel like to say, I just think it's bomb people.
I appreciate that. They hit a little home for me. Thank you.
I can't blame you. I just can't. I'll be like, I got it. I could get it, you know. I just think it's so bomb when I hear people, like, how confident people are in their mental intelligence. I just think that's really bomb.
That is bomb. Yeah.
I need to be more to be like, you know. Not in the business world, girl. You see me in front of a corporate anybody. I'm smart. Yeah. I'm just saying, like, I'm like,
now I'm not gonna say I do a lot of dumb stuff and I just be sitting there like, oh my gosh, I'm so dumb.
Like, none of us are exempt for the stupid decisions that we make.
Like, none of us are. I'm like, dang, I'm dumb.
I'm so dumb. Let me tell you, when I was single, girl, I said shit all the time.
Yeah.
Like, bitch, you stupid. Like, you're stupid as hell. Like, you're an idiot. I'll be pulling up to a nigga house. This is a brown sugar bag. We all niggas.
Speak your truth.
I'll be pulling up to a nigga like, bitch, you stupid as hell. Yeah. Like, you stupid. Or driving away. You're stupid, black shit. I mean,
hey, it's life.
That was me.
That's your learning lesson. That's I feel like that you learned from your stupidity.
Oh, hell yeah, I did. Yeah. When I wanted to. Hello. That's the key.
Yeah.
You have to come back. You have to want to learn.
Yeah. Oh, you know what I can't stand are people who are just like, this is who I am. Like, there's no room for like growth. Oh, I hate that line. Like, this is who I am. It's a flaw. Fix it.
It's not good.
It's not good. Claim to be who you are. You know, when it's a positive thing, you know.
But you know, with people like that, they don't see that as a bad thing, and it'll take them more time to see. They have to go in full circle for them to see that. Hey. That shit was bad.
Yeah. Like,
that shit affects me, and that shit affects my relationships. It affects my life, so I need to change it.
Right.
But a lot of times, I mean, it just takes.
Because one thing I have learned, you can't change nobody. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to say that louder for the people in the back. You cannot change anybody who doesn't want to change. So, I mean, you can point out issues. It's up to that person to realize, like, yeah, this is a problem. I need to fix it. But, in a nutshell, you know, you just got to let people be who they are. I mean, they said what they said. And you can either get with it or get lost.
And that's your choice.
Yeah, it's a choice. Stand there.
I don't enjoy that either. But I feel like I've just learned that, you know, it takes a person to realize that, you know, that affects them for them to make the changes.
Yeah.
Even in my own self, like, you know, because some people, I know it's been time people may have told me that I'll be like, well, no, that's not it. Because I'm being defensive or I'm just not there yet.
You're not open to change.
Because I feel like you have to be in a certain place in your life to even receive it to be able to shift like that.
Absolutely.
Some people don't have the strength. You don't have the knowledge. You don't have the tools to shift the way that you need to shift.
That's what I'm doing right now. I need tools. But, and that's what you guys are going to help me with, because when y'all said what brown sugar was to you, I was like, okay, I need to learn from y'all because I don't have self-love right now. I don't like who I am right now. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to figure out who I am. Because I don't like what I'm doing. Mm-hmm. and I'm not familiar with this person that I'm being, like, I let people walk over me. Mm. Like, I'm scared to be alone. Mm. It's like, it's some shit. But you wouldn't know it because I don't talk about it. I don't have anybody to talk to. Mm. So brown sugar for me is going to be therapy. Mm. Because there are things that are they're going to be topics that we talk about where they do have a special place in my mind, where it's something that I'm harnessing there and I need to let it go. And that's when I'm going to let it go. And then I'm going to be all right.
Yeah.
And I'm going to leave it here. And I can't take anything else with me. Like, I can't put on anybody else's problems, anybody else's problems with me. Like, that's not my problem anymore. You got a problem with me either. What's up? Because I don't have any energy for anybody but myself right now. Yeah. And it's okay. I've never been selfish. But this is the proper time to be selfish for me.
Yeah, absolutely.
So this brown sugar is my selfishness. This is me.
It's about to be very transparent.
It's about to be very open, very transparent. It's going to be deep, but it's going to be very real.
I don't think any of us are afraid to kind of share some stories.
Never afraid.
We're not going to share names, but we're definitely going to share stories. Sure, we're going to be transparent because I really do want you guys to know that, you know, life, you don't go through life by yourself. No. Like, there's always people there to help you over the road. We gonna laugh together. We gonna cry together.
I know. We gonna pray together.
Yeah, we gonna pray together.
We gonna grow.
Yeah, we're gonna do a lot. So we just want just vibe out with us, y'all. Just vibe out. And this show is just all about us letting y'all know what to expect, what to come, what's coming. Cause we have some good things in store. Some good conversation.
Good conversation.
Yeah.
And we promise not to over talk, y'all. Over-talk. I think we wanted to keep the conversations to like an hour, enough to where y'all can drive to and from work and listen to us.
If y'all in Houston traffic on the way home.
Oh yeah, Houston traffic's no joke. So an hour is perfect to tune in. Yeah.
I love listening to podcasts on the way to work. Mm-hmm. And then listen when I'm at work. And then listen to the last bit when I'm going my way home.
Yeah. Absolutely. And we're gonna we're gonna try to attend a couple of events around Houston too. Let y'all know what's going on in the city.
Brown sugar in the city.
Definitely. Okay. Definitely hip y'all to some. What's the better word for y'all?
Expose
or
put y'all on.
Put y'all on game.
Let's just be real.
Cut the shit, right? We're gonna put y'all on game when it comes to like restaurants and like just different like
partying.
Just the events, and just different stuff, concerts, because you know the summer we coming into the new year, so gonna be a lot of festivals and shit like that coming up.
Yeah.
So we want to be able to talk about that and kind of be a, what do they call them, Chloe? Be a media. What is it like? You know, like when you.
You're just puffing events.
But you're like a
spokesperson.
Not really. You just kind of like
I don't know the word.
You like cover. Like you're basically covering the event.
A reporter.
Okay.
Journalist.
I get what you're saying.
But you know certain company, you know how different type like blogs will do it, but it's a certain word.
I know what the word you're looking for, and I cannot get it off my tongue right
they
now.
They do it at like festivals.
Yeah,
and
I know what you're saying.
Like,
you
kind of like email them and send your like you know shit to them, and they'll give you like press passes and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. So anyway, I want to be able to do those things. I don't know.
I'm excited. I'm gonna think of the word 5 minutes later, y'all, and I'm gonna just blurt it out.
But Chloe gets all the passes anyway because she works for the news.
Girl, don't tell that lie. Don't be calling me, asking me for no type of bad.
We get into but I'm gonna say this last thing about what, because this is the most important part to me.
Okay, we keep cutting you off. I'm sorry.
No, absolutely not, never. I wanted to be a part of something uplifting and empowering because of where I am in my life right now. You know, we have those group of friends where we can be bougie with, and then we have those friends that you can be relaxed with, and you don't have to fake like you doing something because everybody's like saying I'm doing this or get your money up type thing. Well, not really like that, but you know, it's so many things out in the world right now that are convincing you that what you're doing is not good enough.
Right.
You don't look good enough. You're not making enough money. You're not taking enough trips. Mm-hmm. And I just wanted to be a part of something where we're all different. But we can all just sit back and relax. Like right now we're relaxed. I was nervous coming over here because I'm like, oh my God, am I underdressed? Like
even podcast. They can't see us.
I know, but I don't girl,
coming to y'all soon, though. We really do want to get cameras in here. We could have filmed. I have a camera. Lo has a camera.
Let's wait.
But yeah, we'll do that later. Correspondent. Was that the word you were looking for?
Media correspondent.
I told you I'll think of it 5 minutes later.
Media correspondents to the events and stuff around the city.
Yeah. I
just want to be a part of something that we're not sitting around gossiping about other people that we know. We're talking about real things. Like, how we going to fix my credit?
How you going to fix my credit? A financial episode.
Like, I need shit that's positive that's going to help me get to the next point in my life. Not something that's going to be good for a couple minutes. Like, because, you know, we like Ratchet TV and it's cool, but Ratchet Life is not the movie.
By the way, speaking of Ratchet TV, I cannot wait for Wax Atlanta to come on January 3rd.
Wax Atlanta, I love Wax, so I wonder how Atlanta's going to be.
I'm a loving hip hop kind of. I haven't watched.
You know, have you seen the previews of the girl with her daddy and the mama?
Miami. I'm excited for Miami. I'm only excited for Miami because of Trina.
Me too.
That's it.
I want to see her.
But I feel like she's not going to make a consistent appearance. She's just gonna kind of be a
Because Trick Daddy's on that fire.
Trina don't need no loving hip hop.
She don't. But you know, she was on Breakfast Club the other day, and she was like, you know, you're not getting on the show without me. So if you're not fucking with me, if I'm not fucking with you, you're not getting on the show.
Oh,
if she said, I was like, okay, what's up?
The baddest has spoken.
Shout out.
Come on, Trina.
What she said? You're not.
What's
gonna
the
get
loading?
You're not. You're not getting on the show. She said you're not
gonna
show
that. So we may or may not have episodes where I'm sorry, I'm smacking. I'm eating popcorn.
She is smacking popcorn.
I apologize. But we may or may not have episodes where we're talking about love and hip hop episodes.
Oh, what we will be talking about is when Insecure comes back on. That's what we will be discussing.
Issa.
Whenever you're ready to take a trip to Houston and join Brown
Sugar
Bay
podcast, I mean, we would love to interview you.
Your biggest fan.
I mean, we have questions about
need to know.
I actually,
it's so funny. I went to Half Price. One of my goals for 2018 is to read more books.
And I'm
trying to at least read a book every other month. I don't want to say every month because it's unrealistic
for
me.
I'm busy. I love that.
So I'm trying to finish a book every other month. And the first book I ordered was Issa Rae's The Misadventures of the Opera Black Girl. So I cannot wait to read that.
We should read that together.
I'm also trying to read Gucci Mane book because I heard Gucci Mane book was really good.
Really?
I heard it was good.
I watched his little show thing, the main event and whatever. I didn't get to see the wedding, but I seen the show.
I haven't seen one episode.
That was horrible publicity to me. I just couldn't. It was just kind of like I realized that something happened in production to where you guys aired the wedding before you aired everything that lit up to the wedding. How did they feel like that was going
to
work?
Well, they wanted to get married on the 7th.
I realized that. But so, who did you think was going to watch all the other episodes leading into it for the next 3 months? That don't make no
people
sense.
People love Gucci.
That's great.
So I'm pretty sure
I just didn't feel like that. I mean, probably. But me, myself, personally, I just... Because I kind of feel like... Okay, listen here. If I miss the wedding, right?
Yeah.
I'm watching all these episodes to see what exactly.
But I heard the last episode is supposed to be a bigger
production of the wedding.
But see, because the wedding was live, quote unquote.
My stupid cable, like, I can't even see that. I'm watching it on demand.
You
but,
got it on demand?
Yeah.
But
sure.
I have AT&T. And AT&T is cheap.
I got AT&T too.
I can't see it. Like, the wedding's not even on there, so I just watched all the episodes for what?
I haven't seen that.
I just felt y'all should have. Now, if they would have did the episodes leading up, I would have lit. I'm like, we watched Keisha about to plan this wedding on trip.
Right.
And then the wedding, oh my God. But y'all done already got married. And so now what I'm watching y'all? Past tense.
I hear you.
This is not reality TV. This is a hoax. I'm bamboozled.
I'm bamboozled.
So what shows besides Insecure and Love and Hip Hop?
Wags Atlanta.
I guess I gotta watch that. I don't watch too much TV.
Real Housewives of Atlanta and Real Housewives of
Beverly Hills. Those are my girls.
See,
I love Beverly Hills.
I don't watch any of that.
I feel like I can relate to them, which is crazy.
We're friends. And we're also Atlanta. We're friends too.
What?
We are. Portia? I want to be Portia. I'm like, Portia, don't worry about them, girl. I'll be your friend.
Whenever you're ready, Portia.
Whenever you're ready, because you can forget all them hoes except Nene. I love Miss Nene.
I do love
Nene.
You
know what I'm saying? Tell me.
Hold up. Let me get her name. Damn. Cynara. You know how you be like, I watch a show and then you can't.
Sheree?
No.
Candy?
Twirly? No. What's the twirly girl?
Kenya?
No. Kenya. What's the other one? What's the other
one? I said the twirly girl. That's what's the only
one. Mona? Oh.
Cynthia!
Cynthia the first time.
I can't find it. She's so pretty. Weak. I don't like her. She a weak peach. I don't like her.
She's so pretty.
She's peach. That was funny.
She's a weak peach because she's just like, I don't like how she's just so like, and she, it's like she's messy. You know, they all messy. But I'd rather you like be messy and be up front with your messiness when somebody call you out. Ooh. Don't like be like,
don't hide behind some shit. And I get scared when the shit hits the fan.
But they're all like that. But Cynthia herself, like it's she just needy. She don't never stand up for herself. Like
why her and Peter broke up?
Girl, that's a whole other thing. I just don't.
Disclaimer: I do not watch.
Okay,
any
I'm sorry.
New Real Housewives.
Disclaimer: Cynthia, babe, like if you ever decide that you want me, you know, come on the show and promote. I apologize. I like you, but I'm just saying I don't like
how you guys come on the show. Okay, Jada, what are you looking forward to?
Jada got to come to the mic if she comes.
Oh, cousin.
Yeah, Jada's here. It's Jada. Jada Cynara's cousin. She's
cousin
joining
Jada.
Us.
What's up, Brown Sugar?
It's kind of like a live audience for us, just with Jada.
What are you into? What shows are you into?
What shows?
What are you anticipating?
Insecure. Power.
I haven't seen that one episode.
Power.
It's so funny. What? I feel like I get yelled at. I've not seen one episode of Power.
It's alright.
And it's not because I don't want to. I just don't watch TV.
Oh.
Yeah.
If I do watch TV, I'm honestly watching Sex in the City.
I love Sex in the City.
Or I'm watching
Waiting to Excel.
She's Gotta Have It. Waiting to. How did you know?
I haven't
Low. I remember one night Low watched Waiting to Excel. I feel like three times back to back.
She's Gotta Have It.
No, She's Gotta Have It. The
show on Netflix. See, I've got to get into
it. I've watched it currently about 10 times.
I heard it was good.
Can you turn it on?
Oh, but of course.
I heard it was good. I heard She's Gotta Have It's good. That's on my Netflix lineup.
Amazing.
I've seen like the first episode.
I watched it.
I just got a Fire Stick, so I've been watching a lot of movies.
Y'all just have to let Nova flow.
Okay, put it. I feel her vibe. I love her vibe.
Let me tell y'all how, it's going to sound weird, but how, it's kind of like helped me and like changed like how.
What? Okay, help me.
How she like vibrates higher.
I heard it's really good.
I can tell.
I've heard good reviews about it. I've heard good reviews.
But let me brag on my cousin really quickly.
Jada
said, let me brag on my cousin Jada. She's my cousin, even though, you know, she's my husband's cousin.
Mm-hmm.
But she's my cousin. Mm-hmm. I love Jada. Jada, you're 21.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, I remember them days.
She's a college graduate, okay? And she's working in her field.
That's what's up.
She don't have no kids. And shout out to the women with kids that are young, because I was 21 and I had a kid. But she don't have no kids. She went to school, and she handled her business, and she's working in her field.
That's what's up.
Shout out.
Jada, what school do you go to?
Oh, well, I went to UNT.
Yeah, she graduated.
Graduated. What's your field?
HR.
Hello.
Let's go.
We're going to fire him and hire him. Yeah,
okay.
So I just wanted to brag on my cousin because she's here, and, you know, you have to... We have, as women, we have to hype each other up.
We do.
Because
absolutely.
No one's going to do it.
No, our audience is kind of Jada. It's just, I really want to get to the younger, the younger
crowd. That's why I
want
to bring her, because
and we're not that old, for anyone who's listening. We're really not that old. We're in our 20s. We're 20-somethings. But, it's just, I really want to speak to that younger crowd, that 5-6 years under.
I want to see where their mind is.
Yeah.
That's why I'm here, because I want to know what you thinking? What you feeling?
And be on your bus, because that's a Brown Sugar bae. She is a boss in training,
a boss
in come up,
a boss. Jada has employees. She's a boss.
Come on. HR. If I don't like you, you're out.
Yeah.
Out of here.
Oh, okay.
Come on.
I know. There's
one.
How much time are we at?
We're
at 54. Oh, we should be. Let's round it out.
I want to end our podcast with something like to think about.
Okay.
So like just last remarks, wrapping it up.
What's our next episode? Let's give them something to tease at. you know, what we're going to talk about so y'all can join in.
Oh, you want to be daddy's girl?
Yeah.
I kind of do.
Our next episode is called Daddy's Girl.
I feel in my heart I'm about to cry already. Like, I'm about to cry. Anybody. Yeah.
Daddy's Girl is going to be really, I won't say intense. It's going to be emotional. We're going to be just talking about the relationship between a woman and her father. And we all have stories when it comes to our dads. You know, some good, some bad. We all have different relationships. So, I know it's a strong topic to start off with, but we really wanted to start off with daddy's girls, just to kind of, you know, we don't hold nothing back.
It's going to snowball into something else. What you hear from us, from daddy's girl, it's gonna
propel us to go in other places.
Yeah.
And honestly, daddy's girls, it's like when you're younger, when you're a kid. So it's like the root of everything. So honestly, that's really a symbolism of like
being a father is a very important
of our
role.
Podcast, like the beginning, our first episode, right? The root. I mean, because you know, your father and your relationship with your father builds you. I feel like that's the root of who you are. As
hello,
a woman.
Amen. Hello, as a woman.
So to speak about that, then to share that with you guys, so that you guys can kind of
talk.
It
kind
of helps you guys to kind of, you know, come along with us personally to see how we are as women and why we are as women.
Because I feel like in that episode, we're going to be tackling some inner issues probably within ourselves that we probably never talked about.
You know what? I can tell you right now, everything that I say about my relationship with my dad is the reason why I am the way I am now.
Yeah.
And we're going to have guests as well.
Yes.
Other girls here who are amazing and awesome chicks. And they're going to be here to share their stories.
Absolutely.
About their dad. So I cannot wait until they get here because they're so excited.
I can't wait. But yeah, I feel like we should leave off every episode with that. It's just like that we're leaving y'all what's to come.
Stay blessed.
Stay blessed. Oh, okay.
Tell me. Let's go.
A positive word or a positive affirmation.
Boom.
About yourself.
About me or something I should share with others?
Whatever.
Something positive that you want to tell to yourself if you were listening to you.
Oh, I wanted to say something about the new year, but I just realized that this is going to air already in the new year.
Yeah.
But I am going to say this is going to air early January. So I just can't say, like, just accept whatever is coming your way in 2018. Mm-hmm. I really do feel like 2018 is going to make sense for everything that may have went wrong in 2017 for you. Mm-hmm. So 2018 is going to bring everything into fruition. So I just want everyone to just be ready for what 2018, what's coming.
Be confident and be ready.
You're ready for your blessings. I was about to break out in worship, but I'm going to just say hey, get ready for your blessings.
Are you ready? For your mirror.
Seriously,
number?
Yeah. That's me.
Let's get some church then. Okay, choir.
I think mine is to... I just had it and I lost it. Hold on, let me get it back. Mine is to... Oh, here we go. Everything that you need is already inside.
It's already there. Ooh. Come on.
And as long as you're intentional about finding it and knowing what those things are, you'll always have them. Like everything else will fall into place because it's all about you, like inside your root. And I just honestly, that shit just clicked for me like a couple hours ago. Like every little thing, like your energies, your everything that you need is inside of you. And you just have to pull those things out.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And everything else, your goals, your dreams, your whatever it is, your changes, your self-transformation, it's all going to fall into place because who you are on the inside is, you know,
what you
the
pour
principles
out
of the things that you need to get you to the places where you need to go.
I firmly believe what you pour out into this world, you will receive back.
And what you put in as well.
Yeah.
So you already have what you need inside of you.
It's already there.
So just believe in it and just step into it and focus on those things. 2018, you're a focus.
Seriously, you are a brown sugar babe in training.
Brown sugar babe,
go get it.
Get it.
Okay,
it's for you. Who's stopping you? If you haven't you know, make plans or wrote anything down. This is your time now. Go ahead and do that now. Get you a notebook. Get you a composition book from Nana Sisko, girl.
I love journals. I love journals.
And budget yourself. If you want to write down all the big items or the big things that you want to do this year, bitch, write that shit down. I don't care if you work at McDonald's. Yeah, bitch. You can get there.
Let's go.
You can own it.
As long as you write that shit down, you have, that is a goal for yourself. And that is something to look forward to. There's something to reach. There's something to wake up for.
Yeah.
Like, hallelujah. You know what I'm saying? Like, I have a goal to reach.
Yeah.
I got something. I said, I'm going to be in Abu Dhabi, bitch, in December. Even if your ass ain't going to be in Abu Dhabi until 2022. It's okay. Like, write that shit down. So, make your budget. Like, that's important. Like, just write down your goals if you haven't done so already. Yeah. Pray about them. Give it to God. And walk in those goals. And walk in those you know, wants or whatever every single day.
Your goals. I like that.
And it's going to come.
That will give you motivation because it's hard.
Yeah.
What? That's what we need to talk about. That's the episode.
Because I know it's people.
Because it's hard as shit right now.
Going into the new year fucked up.
Hello.
You know what I'm saying? Like, seriously, down and out and emotionally. Y'all know how this shit feel. Like,
I don't have it. I didn't accomplish what I wanted to accomplish last year. I'm coming in this year. Stuff's not making sense. And it's just like, don't focus on the negatives. Like, we're going to focus on all positives this year. And this podcast, for the rest of the year, we're all about positivity. We're going to dig into those inner issues, those deeper issues. Because
to fix them.
We're going to fix them. Because I don't like broken people.
No. Build a bridge and get over it.
I don't like it.
Girl, I used to pray. My prayer, I had a broken prayer for like 5 years. Like, Lord, I am broken. Please fix me.
Yeah.
And I used to cry it.
That's
like,
real.
Cry it. Like
that J-Law song, Me Again?
Cry it. And I didn't feel, and I felt so whole within that space with God. Like, just,
I would like for you to share that with me later.
You know what I'm saying?
I would like for you to share
Just saying that, it's power.
It's admitting.
Admitting what's
wrong. I feel like God
wants
you at his most vulnerable. We're going to stop it here because we could go on and on.
Yeah, okay. So let me go ahead. I'm going to just give my last remark.
Okay.
This is my last remark.
Okay.
Trust your struggle.
I like that. I'll put that on a shirt.
Trust
your struggle.
Merch also.
Merch!
Next time. But trust your struggle.
Okay, you guys. So, Happy New Year. It is
Happy
the 8th. Oh, no. It's the 15th. Sorry.
The 15th.
It's the 15th.
Hey, it's whenever we drop it. But no,
it's
coming.
Whenever we drop it.
It's coming.
So, Happy New Year, everybody. It's 2018.
Yes.
Yes.
Happy 2018 from 2017.
From 2017. And make sure you guys tune in to our next episode of Posset. Make sure you subscribe to the podcast channel so that you can get updates when we post. And visit our Instagram Brown Sugar Podcast at Brown Sugar Podcast.
Yeah.
Make sure you follow our Twitter at Brown Sugar Podcast.
Plug,
you email all of your questions at brownsugarpodcast@gmail.com.
She added an extra egg.
I'm sorry.
Just Brown Sugar Podcast.
I got Chardonnay. brownsugarpodcast@gmail.com. And if you would like to follow us, my Instagram is at her name is Lou. That's LEAUX. And
your pusher. Because I'm your pusher.
How you spell that?
P-U-S-H-U-A-H.
So it's Y-O.
Oh, let me go look. Because I ain't
good. I can't.
I'm so sorry.
Because I thought it was like two or three.
It is. Okay, so it's Y-O-P-U-S-H-U-A-H. Your push.
Your pusher. And mine's super simple. It's at Miss Chloe Chantel. That's Chloe with a C. Chantel, Chantel.
That's right, you guys. So if you want to just follow us on our day day or whatever we post, go ahead and do that. But we will catch you guys in our next podcast. Bye, you guys. Y'all stay blessed.
Stay blessed.
And be wonderful. Walk in light, love, and happiness.
Happy birthday.
All right. Bye, you guys.